Dear students, today we talk of gametogenesis. Gametogenesis can be defined as it is the production of gametes from gonads. The gametogenesis includes spermatogenesis and oogenesis. The spermatogenesis is the process of formation and maturation of sperms by testes. Oogenesis is a process of formation and maturation of eggs by ovaries. I will take spermatogenesis. The spermatogenesis includes testes. Testes consists of seminiferous tubules. The seminiferous tubules lined by germinal epithelium. The germinal epithelium contains two types of cells, germ cells and Sertoli cells. Germ cells produce sperms. Sertoli cells are the nurse cells, provide nourishment to developing sperms. The spermatogenesis includes two stages. First one, formation of spermatids and the formation of spores. The formation of spermatid can be studied by three stages. They are phase of multiplication, phase of growth and phase of maturation. First one, multiplication phase. Here the primordial germ cells undergo repeated mitotic divisions and produce many daughter cells called spermatogonia. Spermatogonia are diploid in nature. Second one, now growth phase. Here the synthesis of nucleic acids and protein takes place. Cell sizes become larger and form primary spermatocytes. The primary spermatocytes are diploid in nature. Next one, our maturation phase. Here primary spermatocytes undergo first meiosis to produce two haploid daughter cells. They are secondary spermatocytes. Later, secondary spermatocytes undergo second meiosis to produce daughter cells called spermatids. They are also haploid in nature. Each primary spermatocyte produces four haploid spermatids. This is something about the process of formation of spermatid in three stages, like multiplication phase, growth phase and maturation phase. Later, the spermatid undergo certain changes to form sperms or spermatozoa. The process of conversion of spermatid into spermatozoa is known as spermatelosis or spermiogenesis. Now we will take a spermatelosis. Here spermatid is metamorphosis into spermatozoa. The spermatelosis or spermiogenesis can be studied by certain changes like changes in nucleus, changes in Golgi complex, changes in centriole, changes in mitochondria, changes in cytoplasm. First one, now changes in nucleus. Nucleus is finely depressed, chromosomes are closely packed, nucleolus and proteins are removed. During the changes in Golgi complex, Golgi complex forms acrosome of spore. The acrosome helps in dissolution of egg membranes by the presence of hydrolytic enzyme, that is the hyaluronidase enzyme. During the changes in centriole, the proximal centriole and distal centriole are found at the region of neck, they form axial filament of the spore and also helpful to formation of astes and spindle fibers during the mitotic division. During the changes in mitochondria, the mitochondria form a spiral sheath around axial filament. The spiral sheath of mitochondria around the axial filament is known as Nebenker. It appears like a double helix. The Nebenker provides energy for the motility of developing spore. During the changes in cytoplasm, certain amount of cytoplasm is discarded from spore. The small amount of cytoplasm is retained, that is called manchete. The plasma membrane develops cytoplasmic sheath around spore. So these are the few changes occurs during spermatelosis. They are the changes in nucleus, changes in Golgi complex, changes in centriole, changes in mitochondria and changes in cytoplasm and also plasma membrane. At the end of this process, spermatid is developed into spermatozoa. Next one now, structure of human sperm. Sperm is a slender, motile, active male gamete produced by testes. The sperm consists of mainly two regions, head and tail. The head is oval shape, contains cytoplasm, nucleus, acrosome, and a haploid set of chromosomes. It is covered over by plasma membrane. Acrosome formed by Golgi apparatus and contain hydrolytic enzymes like hyaluronidase enzyme. It helps in the dissolution of egg membranes during fertilization. Next one now, neck. Neck consists of four parts. They are The tail consists of four parts. They are first one now neck, second one middle piece, third one is main piece, and fourth one is end piece. So the sperm consists of two main regions like head and tail. Second one is a tail. The tail consists of four parts: neck, middle piece, main piece, and end piece. Neck is short part of sperm. Middle piece is broader part of the sperm. Main piece is longest part of sperm. End piece is naked part of sperm. First one now, neck. It contains proximal centriole and distal centriole. They form axial filament of the spore. Middle piece. Axial, it consists of axial filament covered by mitochondrial sheath. That is known as Nebenkur. At the posterior end, there is a encircling the axonema as a ring centriole. The main piece consists of cytoplasmic sheath and axial filament. The end piece consists of only axial filament without a cytoplasmic sheath. No covering of plasma membrane. The naked axial filament is the flagellum. The flagellum is vibratile in nature and helps in locomotion or motility of sperm. This is something about the structure of human sperm. Any doubts, any clarification, send me the messages. Thank you.